So, I've got some apologies to make today. I'll just turn Bright Eyes down, because Bright Eyes is song number 10 in my countdown from best songs of 2020 so far. Just turn it down a bit more. Hopefully you can still hear him. Well, them, actually, and that's one of the apologies I'm going to make. Always knew that Connor Oberst was a member of a band called Bright Eyes. However, I'd always assumed that that Connor Oberst was more or less the core part of it. And even Connor Oberst by himself would be qualified to call himself Bright Eyes. I've realised now that's not really the case. Little bit of history. I discovered Bright Eyes quite a few years ago now. I'm going to say around about 2008-ish. Because they were in support of REM when they played in Melbourne. I think they supported them on the whole Australian tour, or probably the world tour, I don't know. Anyway, blew me away. I think it was REM. 99% sure it was REM they were supporting. Anyway, I went out on the strength of that and bought their latest albums. I could have the years mixed up here a little bit, but I'm going to say it was 2008, but now I'm starting to think 2005. Because the albums I bought were Digital Ash in a Digital Urn, which was bloody fantastic. That was the louder electric sort of Bright Eyes album. And that was paired with another album at the same time called I'm Wide Awake, It's Morning, which was more acoustic-y sort of stuff. And that is kind of... Actually, I'm going to make that the basis of my mistake. And my mistake was that I thought everything that Connor Oberst did by himself was, well, we may as well call it a Bright Eyes album, or we may as well call the Bright Eyes albums Connor Oberst albums. That is really not correct now that I've done my homework. I haven't done much homework. But what I discovered was that there is a much bigger and spacious sound to the Bright Eyes stuff. Casadega, and then The People's Key. People's Key in 2011, that was the last Bright Eyes album, and everything in between that has been Connor Oberst, with the Social Club thing, not the Buena Vista Social Club, of course. Did Outer South, the Better Oblivion Social Club, and none of those albums have really blown me away. The only thing that Connor Oberst did by himself that blew me away, and it was a bloody amazing album, was his self-titled album in 2008. Freaking love that album. His collaboration, of course, with the Lobsters of Folk, which was, I've freaking forgotten the rest of the band's names now. I listened to the album hundreds of times. The guy from My Morning Jacket, what's his name? And it might have been Mike Mogus in there as well, from Bright Eyes. Anyway. Great album if you've never heard it. And I've prattled on. I intended to get this done before the song finished, before Persona Non Grata, the song by Bright Eyes that's just come out, had finished. Anyway, I'm just going to start it again. Wait a minute. Hope no one's going to block me on YouTube because I'm... Here we go. I've got my wrong playlists up. Here we go. Persona Non Grata by Bright Eyes. Here we go. In terms of the song itself, look, I may as well forget the history. You can look it up. You've got access to Wikipedia and YouTube and. But Persona Non Grata is the first Bright Eyes song in about 9 years, the last album being People's Key, as I say, everything in between being Connor Oberst solo. And when I first heard Persona Non Grata, I thought to myself, oh yeah, sounds just like every other Connor Oberst song that we've had out for a while. And I think he's bloody fantastic, so every other Connor Oberst song makes for a great song. So I've sat back and thought, is it great? Is it brilliant? I thought, nah, it's just like everything else. But then I listened to it a few more times and it has grown on me. And what I've realised this morning is that I think it's a very, very good Connor Oberst song. It's going to be very, very rude to Connor Oberst. I'm sorry, Connor, I don't mean it this way, but it's a very good Connor Oberst song. but a fair to middling Bright Eyes song. I have to say, I think I prefer Bright Eyes' stuff to Conor Oboe's stuff, which I find that hard to reconcile, given, like I say, the links are core is Conor Oboe's to both acts. And I consider Monsters of Folk, once again, to be a Conor Oboe's outfit, in my opinion. But why did it get number 10? It got number 10 because it's literally just come out. Hasn't had a chance to really grow on me yet. And I'm hoping it will. Might come up the chart a little bit. Or I might realise that it's not quite as good as I think it is at the moment. But I know. Either way, if you're a Conor Oboe's fan, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. If you're a Bright Eyes fan, I think you'll be like, oh goodness, they're back. Thank goodness for that. On the basis of this new song coming out, I'm actually going to go back and listen to The People's Key, the last Bright Eyes album, which I recall I really enjoyed. There's Bright Eyes with Persona Non Grata, song number 10 in the countdown.